The hull of one of the world's largest oil platforms is setting sail on one of the world's largest marine transportation vessels on a voyage to the other side of the planet. This is the story of the journey of the amazing Appomattox oil platform. Engineers hope that in a few days' time, the Appomattox hull will be ready to set sail on an epic voyage. A 14,500-mile journey from Koje in South Korea to the Gulf of Mexico.
I just want to give everybody a heads up on where we're
at. But there's a problem brewing. A massive storm out in the Pacific Ocean, and it's heading their way. In a bid to sail before the storm hits, work ramps up to a round-the-clock schedule.
We got a lot of people who are going to be tired today, going to be tired tonight, so we need to watch out for each other.
The size of the crew is tripled to try to get the hull ready before danger arrives.
So this is the latest weather data we've got.
It's the news the team didn't want. The storm in the Pacific has turned into a super typhoon called Nauru.
We know now that Nauru has changed course over last night into this morning. So now it looks like it's going to be coming through the straits between Japan and South Korea.
If Nauru continues on its present course, it means a direct hit on the shipyard with potentially devastating consequences for Appomattox.
Super typhoons are those extraordinary events, right? The one in 20-year events that you really need to be cognizant of.
The Appomattox hull is surrounded by heavy metal and machinery. The team is faced with a dilemma. To keep it on land and be lashed by waves and construction debris, or put it in the water and try to outrun the storm. To go or not to go? That's now the multi-million dollar question.
Do we move forward? Do we accept these waves? Is this something that we need to stop altogether?
What they have told us is that they need 36 hours to run from the storm. We are planning right now on how do we get the hull out of here.
The decision is made. Rather than wait out the storm, they're going to try and get ahead of it. Using gigantic hydraulics, the 41,000-ton hull is moved inch by dramatic inch across 500 feet of ground and onto a floating dry dock. Tugboats then haul it clear of the shipyard into the bay. It will wait out the night here before being towed into deeper water to meet its ocean-going transport vessel, Costco's gargantuan Xinguanghua. It's a 279-yard-long, semi-submersible heavy-lift vessel that's capable of carrying 98,000 tons. With the super typhoon fast approaching, the dry dock has been removed, and the Appomattox hull floats freely for the first time. Tugs pull the hull a further 6.25 miles to the rendezvous site. The next maneuver is critical. The hull will be pulled over the top of the sunken transport vessel. Once it's in place, the hull and the vessel are de-ballasted, lifting them up out of the water. For a successful maneuver, winds have to be less than 16 knots, and the seas calm. The tugs are struggling to control the hull as the winds pick up.
The seas were a concern, the winds were a great concern. So when you're having a super typhoon bearing down in the area, the winds are high and variable. A couple of times we tried to bring it on, and the winds got to a point where we said, stop.
With the typhoon now less than 48 hours away, things are not looking good.
And the third attempt was probably the closest we could have gotten, but then we ran out of time.
Do we stop for the evening because of light? Do we go back to the dock? Is this something that we need to stop altogether?
By chance, the latest weather forecast predicts a 2-hour window of calm the next morning. It will be their last opportunity to get Appomattox onto its transport vessel before the super typhoon hits. At sunrise, conditions are perfect. The Appomattox hull is slowly floated above the vessel, and the transporter lifts it up and free from the water in a textbook maneuver. The hull now gets out in front of Nauru to miss the potential damage the super typhoon could inflict. They've managed to avoid the storm.
Here we go.
All that planning and all that work, it all paid off. It was a really wonderful sight to see. But that didn't mean the job stopped there. It had a long journey.
The Appomattox still has to complete most of its 14,500-mile voyage from South Korea to the Gulf of Mexico. To get there, it will pass Southeast Asia, steer through the Sunda Strait, traverse the Indian Ocean, and pass around the Cape of Good Hope before crossing the Atlantic. But it now faces another potential problem. The Cape of Good Hope on the southern tip of Africa is notorious for its wild weather, especially in the dead of winter, when the Appomattox will be passing.
At that time of year, you could have up to 8-meter seas coming through there. 30-foot sea, that's an enormous sea.
Just weeks after outrunning a super typhoon, the Appomattox must now travel through one of the world's most treacherous seas.
What does it look like? Are we able to continue? Do we need to stop?
The decision is made to dock in Port Elizabeth on the South African coast and wait for a storm to pass.
We were in Port Elizabeth for about a day because winter storm season is pretty critical down in South Africa.
It's a good call. While Appomattox is safely docked, the bad weather subsides.
It moves through rapidly, and you're able to find that gap between the big events to move through safely. They did a fabulous job coming around the Cape of Good Hope.
With another critical weather event avoided, the hull makes its way across the South Atlantic Ocean, through the warm waters of the Caribbean Sea, and into the home stretch, the Gulf of Mexico. But the Appomattox's battle with the weather is not over yet.
After all of that, you think, this is the easy part, right? We're coming home into the Gulf of Mexico, and then Hurricane Harvey.
This is a Category 4 hurricane. This is going to go up the coast and do a massive amount of damage. A catastrophic event for anyone in the path of this storm.
The wind is pretty strong, the rains are coming in, and the high tides now have come in here at Fulton Beach.
Hurricane Harvey is hitting not only the Gulf Coast, but South Texas, right where you're headed.
And right where hundreds of Shell employees and contractors live and work.
The damage was just unbelievable. Nobody could have expected it.
Appomattox team member Kevin McDonald was hit especially hard.
I'm sitting right now where my workshop used to be. We were in a position where we could not leave, so we were here during a storm. We took a direct hit. The eye came right over us. The entire house was shaking, roof was peeling, walls was vibrating. So all we could do was be thankful we were still alive.
Hurricane Harvey wiped out entire communities and destroyed 135,000 homes.
The co-workers I had that came here and helped me clean up and checked on you, it's been amazing to me. It's a family away from home.
The resilience of the people here, the resilience of their families has been truly remarkable.
Once again, the Appomattox avoids the storm, but arrives in the wake of the devastation. Its presence now gives the team something new to focus on.
Somebody came through the trailer and said, it's here. So we all kind of ran out to the back porch and stood there, and you could see it coming in. It's good. You know, just kind of a, whew, we got it done.
In Ingleside, Texas, work on the Appomattox continues at pace as the infrastructure to process 175,000 barrels of oil a day is installed along with living quarters and utilities for its 180 personnel. 6 months later, work is finally finished. The mighty Appomattox is now ready to complete the final leg of its journey and travel to 80 miles off the coast of Louisiana.
This evening is the evening that the amazing Appomattox will be leaving the shores and go to its permanent site in the Gulf of Mexico.
It's time for it to go, but it's always a strange feeling to see it leave. Sort of like, you know, a child leaving home, going off to college.
Crews work overnight to ensure the final leg of Appomattox's journey goes according to plan. By sunrise, a fleet of tugs are in place, and Appomattox is smoothly towed into the Gulf of Mexico, where it will remain for the next 40 years.
That sense of accomplishment, when you know you've crossed the finish line, it's like you've won the Super Bowl.
In the next episode, watch as the amazing Appomattox reaches its Gulf of Mexico home. With laser-like precision, the crew has to try to connect it to the subsea oil field below. It's a nail-biting operation and involves lowering an object the weight of a space shuttle thousands of feet to the seabed and land it on a half an inch target before the oil can finally flow. Subscribe to Shell's YouTube channel to see more on the amazing Appomattox oil platform and other technology and engineering films from Shell.